she made her way down the Solent, the strains of the music faded away and passengers began to explore the ship. Passengers soon settled into deck chairs on the sheltered promenade deck. Others wasted no time in sampling the sea air on the top decks. Public rooms. No time was wasted in giving passengers instruction and practice in lifeboat drill, and the first lesson was putting on the life belts. In the early hours of Monday morning, the Oriana was steaming in the approach waters of Rotterdam, Holland's main port and one of the busiest in the world. The ship moved upstream towards her mooring berth. Alongside and preparations for landing were being made. While in port, the Oriana will be refueling and we decided to take a sightseeing tour to Amsterdam, and soon we were traveling through the Dutch countryside in a comfortable coach. Half an hour later, we were in the center of Amsterdam. Weather had improved as we boarded the water bus that was to take us on a tour along the canals, which form an important part of the transport system. In Amsterdam, there are over 100 islands linked by 800 bridges, all of which contribute greatly to the charm, beauty, and character of the city. Man. Many people have chosen to make their homes in houseboats, and various types of craft are used for this purpose. Finally, we roamed along the streets in the shopping area, comparing prices and admiring the window displays before returning to the ship. That evening we set sail for Finland and Helsinki, home of the composer Sibelius, whose music forms the background of this particular part of the commentary. Next day we had our second experience of lifeboat drill. This time the ship's crew were involved, and the lifeboats, which each carry 95 passengers, were lowered down the side of the ship. Today, only a few passengers braved the strong winds to play deck games. Local motor launches were used at Helsinki to ferry passengers ashore. At the landing stage, we make for the coach which is to take us on the tour of the city. In the Senate Square, we discover the statue of Alexandra. At the Olympic Stadium, built in 1952, we see the statue of the famous flying Finn, Paavo Nurmi. Here we come to the rather modern but beautiful monument, built in honor of the world-famous composer Sibelius. It's first developed. This unusual church is hewn out of rock on the outskirts of the city. The roof is made entirely of designed copper. Alas, our tour is ended as we return to the landing stage for transportation to the Oriana. In the afternoon, we set sail for Stockholm. Some of the ship's launches were used at Helsinki, and they were now being hauled into position. The pilot who is to guide us to Stockholm comes aboard. The Oriana is the largest vessel ever to negotiate the approach waters to Stockholm. It represented an unusual navigational challenge because the waters, known as the Hawk-Bosundet Channel, contains over 1,000 small islands, some only 50 foot in length. At times, the Oriana was so close to the shore that you could almost see inside the houses built on the slopes of the mainland. It was a long haul up the channel, and many passengers took to sitting about reading or drinking coffee or just chatting. The weather remains dull as we continue our way to Stockholm. Interested in a swim than the views outside. As we neared Stockholm, many private craft came out to greet us on this historical occasion. Eventually, we anchored in the harbor, and the ship's advance shore party prepared to make for the quayside. In the meantime, we took the opportunity of filming some of the prominent buildings. At last, we find ourselves heading for the landing stage. noticed this boat decorated with branches and are informed that today is a special holiday in Sweden, and to mark the occasion, they decorate the boats in this manner. Here is another one. Years to build. At this point, we are able to walk around the narrow streets of the old town. Of the town command beautiful views of the whole area. We constantly get sight of our ship in the harbor. We move on, passing the university and the stadium, on our way to the Miles Garden Museum. This is the Carl Miles Museum. Miles was a famous Swedish sculptor, and he built this beautiful garden in 1908 and left it to the nation. There are many unusual sculptures to be seen. This one is called God's Hand. We continue our tour, moving back to the harbor area. This beautiful ship used to be a training ship, but now serves as a rest center for travelers on foot, where they can get rest and refreshment. It is beautifully maintained. One can imagine how stately she looked when in full sail. We return to the Oriana to play the gambling tables, or just watch others match their wits against the odds. The Joker 7 table is very popular, and you can have a lot of fun and even come away winning for just modest outlays of 10p minimum. Popular deck feature is the cricket match between passengers and ship's officers. Some of the participants have obviously played before, and there is very keen rivalry between them. so we come to the end of another day at sea. Next morning, we are approaching Copenhagen, having completed 660 miles from Stockholm. Tankers are soon alongside, pumping in a supply of oil, which will see the ship through to Southampton. Copenhagen, we are able to berth alongside, and at 9 o'clock are descending the gangway. Before proceeding into town, we are able to take a closer look at the Oriana. Entrance to the Tivoli Gardens. Here we take a look at the town hall as we reach the town hall square in the center. This is the largest square in Copenhagen. We make our way towards the inner harbor, passing the Nielsen's Monument. And here we find boats from many parts of the world, including a large luxury yacht. And this is the famous statue, the Little Mermaid, inspired by Hans Christian Andersen. We walk back through the park and then do some shopping in a large departmental store. With its canals of and finally, we make a brief visit to the Christiansborg Palace. By 7:30 next morning, we were heading through the Sound, bound for Norway and Oslo. Our speed was slow, for we had only 40 miles to complete, and arrived at Oslo at noon. Our background music is by the Norwegian composer, Grieg. We see the construction of a North Sea oil rig. We began our tour through the city in unsettled weather. With weather like this, no wonder he cries. Here we have stopped at the Frogner Park to view the famous Gustav Wieland sculptures. There are many fountains and statues in stone, iron, and bronze depicting the seven ages of man. This column is known as the monolith. Set in beautiful gardens, the park took 30 years to complete. This is the Oslo ski jump, situated just outside the city. Norway has had many famous skiers over the years, and many must have practiced to perfection on this jump. Here we stop for a break and to enjoy the splendid panoramic view of the area. This is our last call before returning to the ship. Today, as we head for Southampton, it is our turn to visit the bridge and have the intricacies of navigating such a large vessel as the Oriana explained to us. The duty officer also assured the ship. The dining room was large and comfortable and always clean and neatly set. We had many delicious meals during the voyage, served by the very efficient Goanese waiters. At last, after 3,400 miles, we end our very enjoyable cruise back at Southampton.